Good evening. My name's Cameron here. I'm going to talk to you about the new extension for your browser directly from Obsidian, the team behind Obsidian. And it's kind of, I haven't used it yet. I'm going to set it up and do it all right here with you. We're going to figure it out. It was kind of announced a little bit while ago. And then on Twitter, Obsidian and Capano, one of the developers of Obsidian, were tweeting about it a lot. And I was like, oh yeah, I haven't toyed with that yet. I'm a Readwise user. I use Readwise and I use Readwise Reader. I don't think this would replace Reader because they're just different things. But if you just use Readwise and maybe their extension that lets you highlight stuff on the web, this could be a replacement for you. I guess we'll see. It seems to be available for pretty much any browser. If you go ahead, click on the little extension things, you'll find a manage button there somewhere, and then you'll find at some point something that will say find more add-ons, get more add-ons, something like that. I'm using Firefox right now. So that's this one right here, Obsidian Web Clipper by Obsidian. Bring the web to your personal knowledge base. Save content to your Obsidian vault so you can always have access to it even offline. Whether you're researching for projects, saving recipes, bookmarking travel destinations, or collecting inspiring articles, the Obsidian Web Clipper helps you organize your ideas. Clip anything from news articles, blog posts, recipes, product pages, research papers. If it's on the web, you can save it. Sounds good? As we all know, the web has gotten a little hectic, a little clunky, a little chaotic. So we'll see how this grows. Select page content. Clip entire pages, selected text, or let the clipper intelligently extract just the main content. Customizable templates. Create tailored templates to automatically extract metadata from web pages. Perfect for academics, movie buffs, book lovers, or anyone who wants structured notes. So I think this reads as if it's something you do in the extension options versus an Obsidian template file to use. Smart triggers. Set up rules to automatically apply the right template based on the website you're clipping. It says set up rules automatically. So it's probably, I'm sure you can trigger domain names, but also other stuff. I guess we'll see. All your clips flow directly into Obsidian in the vault and folder of your choice. All right, let's give this a whirl. So they list a couple of different types of web pages. So we've got a chicken enchilada recipe right here. And if you just take a quick look at this website, you can just lose your sanity over it. It's got obnoxiously large images. It's got so many moving ads. It's got a thing down here. It's got a thing over here. This is a disgusting website. This is an absolutely, like, my stomach is not feeling well right now just from looking at this webpage. So let's go here. Let's click this, open it. And we can already see. Okay, so it's got some properties, some default properties that it wants to put in there. Title, chicken enchilada recipes. Sounds good. What's down here? Can we edit this? Is it going to close on me? No, we can. Give me some oven. Okay, that's the website. Source is the URL. Author, Ali, with, we can see it's got some double bracket action going on. And then it's got the URL itself. Like the full URL. And obviously you can change all this. It seems like you can just type right in there. Is that the same as the source? It's just a wiki bracket source. Yeah. And then we've got a Facebook link. Give me some oven blog. So somewhere on here, they've got that. They've got the their official links. It looks like it's grabbing. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Published 2019. Cool. Dated 2024/11/11. So that would be when this note, this clipping, is clipped from the website. Description. My all-time favorite chicken enchiladas are easy to make, customizable for your favorite fillings. Tags, clippings. Is this a little preview? My favorite chicken enchilada. I don't know what this is going to look like, though. We've got a highlighter. Let's just highlight some stuff and see how that goes. Whoa, look at that. Look at that. We've got a yellow dotted line over the elements as we move our mouse cursor. Let's highlight the image. Hmm. Do I have to clip the entire thing or can I click and drag? I can click and drag. And I can just click the whole thing. It looks like if I mouse over this URL, it kind of clips just the sort of surrounding context of the URL. Now, I don't know where it's going because I didn't go into the options. I've got a test vault up here. I've got a little clipping folder. Maybe it just saves it like in the extension and until you tell it. Let's see. Chicken. Beans. Okay, so clip highlights. Oh, this pops up again. So this is going to be just, yeah, chicken, beans. Okay, so that's just what I've highlighted here. So let's go add to Obsidian. Let's see what happens. Allow the extension Obsidian Web Clipper to open the Obsidian link with System Handler. Open link. Is that going to open up Obsidian? Oh! Okay, we've got it in there. So it made a new folder named Clippings. So the one that I did was not used. That's fine, though. I mean, it's fine for this example to see how it works. Obviously, you would want it to go into whatever folder you want. And you might not want it to be named Clippings. But okay, so author, we've got all of those links. Source, give me some oven. Chicken enchiladas. We've got the image right here. And if we click it, we can see that it's just pulling it from the website. Okay. And then we've got the random clippings I've done. We got that red sauce. Again, just not saved from the website, but just, you know, externally pulling it. Chicken beans. Okay. The best chicken enchilada recipe. So this is from Skinny Taste. I want it to do its own highlighting, though. I want it to find out. I want it to decide what the main content is, and I want to see how that compares. So let's take that off. So let's click the gear and see if there's actually settings that pop up. So by default, clip notes are saved to the currently open vault. You can add vaults here if you want the option to save to different vaults. Okay, so this one is just a demonstration, right? We'll just put the name in there so it always saves there. Default templates, export all settings, import settings. Import settings is probably going to be cool. Because I would expect the Obsidian forum and probably the Reddit might have people sharing templates and sharing the automatic rules and stuff that they end up using, which could be pretty interesting. Properties. So this is the default properties, as you can see. Import properties, export properties. So I would suspect same with this. People might be exporting the property setups for certain websites and things like that, and people might be sharing them. So always show highlights. Display your saved highlights when you load a page. So if I reload, oh no, that's a Skinny Taste. Give me some oven. If I reload this, is it going to show me? It does, yeah. Okay. So as long as that maintains, that's pretty cool. That's one of the things I like about the Readwise extension is it keeps track of everything that I highlight. And so there have been times where I'm like researching like how to fix a problem I'm having with a piece of software. And then I come across a website and I see the highlights that I've done, you know, years ago or something. And it just clues me in like, oh man, like it's so useful. Okay, this will have something that I need. And I know that the highlighted parts are going to be the relevant sections for me. So that's very cool. Let's go back to the settings. Behavior. Create new note. Add to an existing note at the bottom. Add to an existing note at the top. Add to daily note at the bottom. Add to daily note at the top. Interesting behaviors. I quite like that. Template triggers. Define rules to automatically select this template if it matches a URL pattern or contains schema.org data. One rule per line. Pretty easy. Properties to add at the top of the clipped note. And there's the content. I mean, I think this is great. The Readwise export stuff to Obsidian gets you a good deal more customization, but I don't really feel like people really utilize that too much. I don't think they really want a lot of customization, which isn't to say that it's bad to have the option there, but I just think it's probably not needed for this specific use case, you know? I think the simpler is better for most people when it comes to stuff like this. New template, so we'll call it sent to sandbox, and that'll go to the vault that's not open right here. Okay, let's go to this recipe. Now, let's see if I can have it just do its own thing. Oh, so we got a drop down right here. What, which one do you want to send it to? That's the folder name. This is also the, we got template up here. So send to sandbox. or default. Default has demonstration, sent to sandbox, changes it to quick sandbox. So I guess if I just leave it like this and I just go add, it will kind of do its own thing and figure out what to include and what not to include. So we've switched over automatically. Obsidian pops up. It switches over to the other vault that was closed, the sandbox vault. And we've just got the whole blog post right here. Now, it doesn't look like the images have saved. Some of them have. So just specific images are broken. Oh yeah, I mean, we had some up here right before it too, so. But this one's not opening up. Okay, not bad. I mean, we got a checkbox here or something. Like, it's cool. I think this is great. And honestly, even being a Readwise user, I adore the product. There's definitely value in being able to just very easily save a full blog article or something right into the your vault. So that is the Obsidian Web Clipper from first party, straight from the Obsidian crew themselves. I think it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. I can't wait to see what others start doing with it. And I think it's probably a no-brainer addition to anyone's vault. If you ever do any sort of referencing of web materials at all, it seems like it's something that could be very useful for anyone. So, and then obviously it's only going to get better. So there's a brand new extension. So great starting point. Can't wait to see where it is, a few months or a year down the road. It's fun. It's cool. Go check it out.